guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to see the operating mode of transistor. So transistor can operate in the three reasons: transistor as an amplifier, transistor as a switch, and transistor in the cutoff region. So the one of the operation of transistor is the transistor as a switch. So to study this mode of the operation, we have a trainer board, transistor as a switch. Order code for this training kit is 36308. So now our first experiment for this training kit is to study transfer characteristic of a transistor. So in this transfer characteristic, I am going to measure the rise time and fall time for the waveform that we are getting in the CRO display. So to observe the waveform, I have a circuitry in the manual. This is the figure 3. Now I am going to start reading the procedure. So feed the square waveform input of 3 volt peak to peak to the circuit as shown in figure 3. Its frequency must be the highest possible. So here I am going to feed the square waveform. Here it is written that input external oscillator square waveform 50 kilohertz to 150 kilohertz. It means higher frequency square wave. So to make this circuit, feed the square waveform using the function generator. So here I am connecting the function generator at high and low terminal of input external oscillator wave 50 kilohertz to 150 kilohertz. So here, and now I am going to observe the transfer characteristic of transistor as a switch on the CRO. So to observe the waveform, I am going to connect the CRO in the output terminal. And also I am going to observe the function generator. So now here I have connected the input from the function generator, and also I am going to observe the input in the CRO also, and I am also going to observe the output in the CRO. So to perform this experiment, turn on the training kit, turn on the CRO, and feed the square waveform using the function generator. And as I am told you that we have to feed the square waveform of higher frequency. So here I am going to set the function generator on the square waveform. Now I am going to apply the higher frequency. So as I am changing the frequency of function generator, you are going to observe that so here I have fitted the frequency, higher frequency, from 50 kilohertz to 150 kilohertz. So now I'm going to vary the frequencies using the function generator, and we are going to observe the CRO display. So you can see, as I have started the increasing the frequency from 50 kilohertz to 150 kilohertz, so you are going to see the waveform as I have mentioned in the manual. So you can see in the manual we have given the same waveforms. So this is the output waveform that I have observed in the CRO, and this is the input waveform that I have fitted from function generator. So our experiment is to measure the rise time, fall time of this output waveform. So to measure the rise time and fall time, we are going to use the CRO. So here you can measure the rise time from here. So as I have clicked the rise time, so we are waiting for the rise time. So So this is the channel 1 function. So we have to make it channel 2. So here you can see the rise time is 200 nanosecond. Similarly, you can measure the fall time. So to measure the fall time, press next. Here I have, now we have to click on the fall. So now you can see the fall time of the waveform is also, this is for channel 2. We have to make it channel 1. So as I have started increasing the frequency, you can see the output form rise time and fall time are written here. Now, so you can see here rise time is 1.6, fall time is 3.6. So you can vary the frequency using the function generator and you can measure the rise time and fall time for the waveform that we have observed in the output. So this is the waveform in the output and same waveform we have given in the manual. This is the output waveform of transfer characteristic of transistor as a switch. So this is all about this experiment. So you can measure different time, delay time, rise time, on time, duty cycle, etc. Now we are going to perform the second experiment, that is transistor as a switch application. So we are going to see the switch application of transistor. So for the transistor as a switch, connect the input 5 volt DC here and we are going to see that for when the input and output junction of the transistor is forward bias, it means transistor behave as a switch. When the both the junction are off, the transistor is in the cutoff region. So to see the transistor as a switch, connect the input 5 volt from here, negative from here. So when the input and output junction of the transistor is in the forward bias region, transistor will work as a switch, and when it is in cutoff region, it will work as a, when both the junction are in reverse bias, transistor will work as a cutoff, means off. So here I have turned on the training kit. Now you can see here relay is activated and in output we have seen that LED is blinking. It means here the transistor is, here the both the junction of the transistor is forward bias, it means transistor will on. So transistor is behaving as a switch, and when I am going to decrease this knob in the anti-clockwise direction, you can see the LED goes off. It means transistor in the cutoff region, means the switch is in off condition. When it is, this is the on condition of transistor and this is the off condition of the transistor. So this is all about this experiment. Here we have learned that how transistor worked as a switch. So thank you for watching video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.